Tale of the Tape is sponsored by Corona, who invites you to find your beach. And there is Tugstsogt Nyambayar, 2012 Olympic silver medalist, also a silver medalist 3 years earlier at the World Championships. He's only 24 years old, 7-0 with 7 KOs. Jhon Gemino comes in with a record of 15-7-1, also a young guy, only 24 years old. Huge step up against a prospect. Again, obviously, this is a kid with a tremendous amateur pedigree. And Nyambayar comes in, having moved to Los Angeles in 2014. 7-0, 7 KOs. We'll get to see that level of class, I would think, pretty early. Virgil, 130 amateur wins.
A silver medalist, we're definitely going to see that level of class. And Amino's going to see it unless he comes ready. Good jab by Amino.
Amino only his third fight in the United States, again coming out of Lipa City in the Philippines, obviously inspired by Manny Pacquiao. Immediately gets to throw. Some crisp shots, good uppercut. Just to let him know you're there. Good counters immediately by Nyambayar.
Very sharp counter. You can see the pedigree right away, Abner.
Yeah, Nyambayar definitely let him know that he was there also. Tagged him really well, showing the pedigree like you mentioned. Great jab right there as we see. Great head movement, 1-2.
Said in 2012 in his gold medal fight, the whole city stopped. And that's a city of 3 million people back in Mongolia. So a big star back there, probably can walk the streets of Los Angeles just fine. Nobody will stop him and have any idea he's a national hero. Good body
get
shot
him
by
up,
him
either. Get him up.
Amino has come to fight. He's got somewhat crude skills, but you can tell that he's a fighter by instinct. So you always have to be careful.
Yeah, Gemino is coming out of impoverished circumstances in the Philippines. You know, I asked him yesterday, hey, what are your goals, your dreams? And he didn't say, you know, glory and championships. He said to get out of poverty. You know, he needs money.
Yeah, that was deep. That was strong,
yeah.
What he said. And the life that he had, I believe he was an orphan kid.
He's an orphan, yeah.
Yeah.
Lives in, again, in a large city, in Lipa City, but within that, in a small village, kind of a typical circumstance in the Philippines. Does his training in, they say the training center has two walls. Now, no roof, no other walls all around. It's just kind of, you know, there, out in the woods.
Yeah, when he said it's open, I thought it was open to the public. No, but
it's open.
He meant it was open, no roof, no.
Literally. Yeah, a lot of fighters, you know, coming up. And later on, we have Caleb Plant, and it was also very emotional, Plant telling us, hey, look, I have no plan B. This is it. I need to make boxing work. And the same thing here for Gemino. And he gets a big fight, has to take a fight like this, but it's against a top-level amateur in Tugstsogt Nyambayar.
Gemino already has a swollen lump under his eye from a Nyambayar's jab. But poverty is a great motivator.
Good counter right from Nyambayar.
10 seconds, boys. 10 seconds.
Well, he came to fight. Gemino trying to make it work. Nyambayar, so far, nice opening round. Did what he had to do. We step away for a moment against Nyambayar, 7-0, 7 KOs. We'll be back for round two after this. We had quite a night on Fox. 3 knockouts. And all, like, very, very different between Dominic Brazil and Izo Ugono, Tony Harrison, Jared Hurd with a comeback knockout, Deontay Wilder with a comeback knockout.
And Brazil with a comeback knockout.
Yes, you're correct. Okay.
Yeah. All three
I'm trying to mentally
knockouts.
Process it, Virgil. You're right.
Yeah.
No, you're absolutely right.
Well, we might be knockout drunk tonight. That's why we process it.
With any luck.
Yeah.
And here Tugstsogt Nyambayar. Again, interesting to see. As he comes up, you know, you wonder how will he be matched? Is he capable of winning a world championship? Because when you're like a silver or gold medalist, that's the target at that point. You're world class. You wonder if this is a guy who can grab a belt at the very least.
Well, he's shown his pedigree, as I said earlier, and he's fighting this Gemino very smart. Gemino is very aggressive. He's an instinctive fighter, and he's strong. If you look at his legs and his upper body, he's a very strong fighter, and he's game. He's smiling, and he's having fun in there. He's not laying down for the pedigree or the silver medal.
Gemino with a good stiff jab and is making it competitive. Abner, how quickly can you get a sense of a guy? Again, from what I said, again, you've won titles in four weight classes. Is this someone that you can get a read on as the level at? Because there is a big difference between the amateur and the professional ranks, of course.
Definitely, of course. And let's not forget I was an ex-Olympian, too, just like Nyambayar. But Gemino definitely giving him, you know, a tough fight. He's not impressed by any of this. You know, at the end of the day, it's boxing. He's seen this before. He's got way more experience as we see him land the hook right hand. He's doing a really good job at Gemino at the moment. I don't think he's impressed by Nyambayar's pedigree or resume.
Yeah, I have to say, just as you're speaking there, you're going to the body nicely. There's a nice right hand. He's letting it fly, letting those combinations fly, Virgil.
He is. He's very determined to win. And again, an instinctive fight is difficult to fight because you never know what he's going to come with. And he's athletic when you really look at it. He can get low to the ground. He can explode from any position. And he's giving Nyambayar a good go.
I asked Nyambayar, how did he define his style? He said he was a pressure fighter. He was an aggressive fighter. I have not yet seen that. he's a poised fighter. He's staying, you know, mid-range, trying to pick his punches.
His counter game looks pretty strong.
Yeah, his counter game definitely is strong. But I want to see that amateur, you know, pedigree, amateur side out of him, meaning, you know, a little bit more counter fast. You know, right there, he's got the advantage there. Let him go.
He's waiting to counter Nyambayar. Gemino right there as he's coming face off and squared up to him. But Gemino again, with the way he throws punches,
nice combination.
Is throwing him off his rhythm right now.
Virgil, I'm sorry to jump in there, but that was stylish what he threw right there. Gemino, nice round. And I'm thinking he won that round. Like, I'm not scoring it as I'm talking about it, but pretty sharp work by Jhon Gemino.
He had a good case. Very good case.
There's Jhon Gemino. His trainer is Ichi Yoshikawa out of Tokyo, Japan. And Virgil, I got excited. I jumped all over you. I'm sorry. I'm not supposed to do that. But I got excited because I saw that, like, a real funky combination from Gemino. What do you make of that?
As I watched it along with you, Brian, again, being an instinctive fighter, he'll show you skill 1 second, he'll show you crudeness the next. So it throws you off, particularly if you're used to seeing a particular style.
Right. You know what? What was impressive there was there was clearly no thought involved.
Exactly.
Right. It just flowed. It looked nice.
And it looked that beautiful. Exactly. You don't think you just let go natural. It just looks that finesse. That much better.
Shoots out a jab as.
Now right here you see he comes right back. A fighter right there. He's a fighter right there. See. And there's the boxer with the jab. So he's showing you so many different looks.
He is.
Good shot.
Ooh, he got caught with the right hand.
Nyambayar answering back after the aggression from Gemino.
Very sharp right here.
Yeah, there's real power in the hands from Nyambayar, you can tell. But Gemino again coming in and throwing sharp combinations. Fluid, aggressive.
Nyambayar is looking to counter with the left hook or the left uppercut. He just threw it but missed it.
I think that Nyambayar is just throwing for just to throw. I think he should lay back a bit. Don't get too close there. He's mothering his punches. He needs to stay at a good range, pick his punches, and make sure he hurts the guy.
Those right hands didn't miss by too much. Nyambayar came in. Didn't quite land flush, but there's real danger there.
No body work yet from Nyambayar. I want to see that a bit. Mm.
Brian Kenny, Virgil Hunter, and Abner Morris here ringside. Christine Leahy with us as well. We were fortunate enough to have Evander Holyfield with us tonight. That was a lot of fun. While we were getting the announcement for Deontay Wilder, we had Larry Holmes walk by and say hello. I hear Ernie Shavers is here. I did not see Ernie, but I hear he's here. You're talking about some great heavyweights in the house.
Boy, what a lineup.
And this is a nice, crisp fight.
He heard Gemino with that right hand.
Gemino
is showing effects of the punches. Both of his eyes are swelling and closing.
And look, clearly there's an A side and a B side. And Gemino comes in. The record is 15-7-1. You know why the guy is here. But Gemino is saying, no, I'm not here for that.
No, he's definitely not an opponent. He he's in this fight at this point. He's not an opponent. And it's a good fight for Nyambayar in his development.
Right.
Oh, sharp right hand, lightning fast, and Gemino goes down.
And gets up and laughs. He got up and laughed, though. Big right hand, and it kept most of the fighters down.
It was one of those flash right hands that you just don't see, and just boom, he goes down. It didn't hurt him.
You know, speaking of beautiful, that right hand, wow, fast. Gemino didn't see it. Gemino with a good motor, and he smiles, taps the glove. But again, that's a 10-8 round because of a beautiful right hand right here. Wow.
Very sharp right hand. Woo. He's been showing a sharp right hand.
Beautiful
right
work.
Over the top.
We return, and this is Virgil worth another look.
Oof. Very nice over the top right hand. Gemino putting out a lazy jab, and Nyambayar capitalized on it right on the button.
That was exactly what I was hoping for Neymar, you know, to pick his punches. Don't just throw, pick your punches.
That's like, that's, you know, the 6-inch punch, Bruce Lee style, you know? It's like, bang, right. He's holding it in the air, and then suddenly it just snaps right off. Didn't bring it back,
there
didn't
it
load
again.
It up.
I wonder what effect it had on Nyambayar when Gemino got up and laughed at him. He showed no effects at all. The punch.
No, but we both know that when a man, you know, fighter laughs or smiles during the fight, it's because he's hurt.
Yeah.
I mean, Gemino, though, he does. He looks like a happy warrior.
Yeah.
But
Nyambayar,
he is a happy camper.
But that's like when you hit a ball perfectly. You know, when you just, or you throw a punch perfect, you just go, oh,
right,
look at that.
Spot.
Has to feel so good. Abner, you ever feel that? You throw a shot, and you barely even feel that you touch the guy, and he goes down?
Yeah, it happened before, and it feels so good. Like, I didn't even mean to hurt him, honestly. I just wanted to connect.
See,
that's where Nyambayar shouldn't be. I mean, he's hurting the guy. He could do work there, but he's got to let go. He's thinking too much. There it is, good right hand, overhand.
And the hook, oh, uppercut. That snaps the head back on Gemino, and now Nyambayar starts to do some damage, just forced him down there.
Yeah, he's really picked up his pace this round. He's showing the aggression you were looking for, champ.
Yeah. He's got to pick his punches, though. He sees the guy going down. Why not work that uppercut?
Exactly.
Body shots. His elbow bit there.
Yeah, looking to come with the right uppercut and the left hook.
A good jab from Gemino as he battles back. Again, the fighting spirit is definitely there for Jhon Gemino.
That's the distance I want. From there, a 3-4 punch combination will definitely hurt the guy.
He's really starting to pick it up, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Tugstsogt and Nyambayar just with more length. And if the fight is fought at that distance, he'll have an easy time.
Definitely will. Makes it easier for him to counter, to land. Now he's just waiting for a mistake, as we can see. There he was.
Gemino trying to make it happen again. That could be a dangerous place as well.
10 seconds, boy.
Nice work, body and then head. Gemino tries to battle back. But another Chris Brown by the Olympic silver medalist. We're back in Birmingham in a moment. Had a great night on Fox as well here in Birmingham. Again, Deontay Wilder knocking out Gerald Washington after Washington seemingly was winning most every round. Jared Hurd came from behind to win the IBF junior middleweight belt against Tony Harrison. Harrison was controlling the fight. And we saw Dominic Brazil come back against Izu Ugono. Ugono, I would love to see him again. I know hopefully people that are watching this fight that are still with us that will watch it on Fox, but Ugono from Poland, parents born in Nigeria, I'd love to see that guy fight again.
Well, he definitely needs to come and fight again in the States. He's an action fighter. He needs a little more seasoning. I think they should drop the level of down a little bit with the opponent so he can continue to develop. He's 30 years old, so he still has time.
And here Tugstsogt Nyambayar out of Mongolia, taking on Jhon Gemino of the Philippines. Gemino putting up a very game effort. Good body shot and then a sharp combination. And now he winds up and there's that right hand again. That has very good power from short distance.
Beautiful combination. He went to the body, back up to the head, and then across with a hook.
You know, Virgil, I was just about, I was about to say, hey, at a certain point, we have rounds 5, 6, 7, like, you'd have to start thinking about, hey, are you sure you're winning these rounds? You know, if you're in Nyambayar's corner, like, are you sure? Because you just can't leave it, because this guy will keep throwing. And then he does what he just did,
right,
take control, and look like he's about to take him out.
Well, Nyambayar has always looked in control in the fight, but Gemino has looked like he could be right there, and he's dangerous at all times.
Well, it's landing punch, you know, it's scoring shots. It's not, this guy looks better. He has a knockdown, so he has one 10-8 round, but it comes down to scoring shots, and Gemino is, again, that motor's running.
Exactly, but Nyambayar is starting to slowly breaking down now. He knows it's a 10-round fight, so he's not putting on the gas too soon, but he's starting to step on it now.
Good jabs coming out from Gemino. And a hook, right hand. As you see, he will have his moments.
See, those are the type of opportunities you don't want to give a guy who has nothing to lose. You know, Gemino, he came here to win, definitely, obviously. But, you know, from a prospect, Nyambayar, definitely being an ex-Olympian, he can't give him those shots. He, right there, you got to finish, find the way to finish the guy. Not make it as complicated. He's not working the inside punches, the uppercuts that I wanted. Body shots, I think those will definitely take him out.
Gemino with a lot of hard work, coming off the ropes, firing back.
If you look closely now, champ, Nyambayar is catching everything on the gloves, the counter. If you look closely now, he's catching everything.
Not those folks.
He caught those with his face.
I'd like to see the replay.
All right, Virgil, are we doing this?
Yeah. I'd like to see that last exchange on the replay.
Maybe we will. Gemino, a little spirited effort there. I don't know. That's an interesting round. We're not scoring the fights, we're calling it. But it's
I don't know if this is the replay.
This is earlier.
This is earlier.
Don't get on his neck.
This is the good work there from Tugstsogt. We'll be back. Maybe we'll do it on the after show on FoxSports.com. We'll be here till 1 a.m. arguing.
Watch closely, obviously.
No, you're right. And then at the moment you said it, then I think he was catching him. At least Abner's in my corner for now. Brian Kenny and Abner Morris here with Virgil Hunter, ringside in Birmingham. Had a great night of fights on Fox. You see, this is how you're scoring it at home. Yeah, interesting. You got just one round so far out there to Gemino, and I think that's fair. There may be another one. Maybe not.
Watch.
No, he's definitely catching the punches with the gloves, doing a fantastic job. But, you know, one or two punches might slip in there at time to time. But why give the fighter that advantage? Why give him that opportunity, as we see right there?
Hammering right hand to Nyambayar's head.
Again, those body work, uppercut. I mean, at the end of the day, like you say, Coach, he might be catching those punches, but the referee might be seeing, you know, a win for this guy.
Exactly.
He's winning those rounds.
Or the judges.
Just by doing
I think Nyambayar is looking for the counter punch. He's looking to stop him, and that's what he's doing. He's trying to open him up.
I think that there's an easier way to stop this guy. I mean, not no disrespect to Gemino. He came to fight.
He's a sharp right hand.
There it is.
He said it was a push.
Chopping right hand, and the count is on.
Smiling.
Yeah, he is being broken down, but again, the spirit is there, but those shots finally landing cleanly, and he cannot afford it. Oh, and another right hand, and he's knocked down again.
How much more punishment can he take? This is six round.
He's been getting broke down, and that's why Nyambayar would stand close to him to force him to punch, though, so he would open up.
Nyambayar looking to close the show. Gemino making his last stand.
Gemino coming back with his punches also.
Oh, he's firing hard, Abner. No
question. He's extremely game, no doubt about that, Jim.
Spirit is willing. Mm-hmm. Trapped in the corner now.
Gemino waiting for him to leave so he can counter.
Joe Goosen yells, don't wait, and don't wait.
And beat him to the punch. He's counter-punching him when he's on the ropes.
Thudding right hand by Nyambayar.
I think he's more effective when he's countering. Because Gemino throws the wide punches and he leaves himself open for counters. If you lead, you could get caught with some of his wide shots.
Get off his neck.
See, right here.
Referee says, no, I didn't tell you to break.
He looked at the ref like, yeah.
Come on,
happened?
Man. Yeah, come on, man. He may have said something. I don't think he told him to break, so that's not an illegal shot. It's a good, crisp action. Well, again, Iji Yoshikawa is in the corner. Again, Yoshikawa out of Tokyo, Japan. And he knows this is a big chance for Gemino. Gemino has shown great spirit. And he's given everything he can. You see him, even at the end of the round, he is firing. But the reason we even ask it, of course, Virgil, is at a certain point, the trainer has to say, look, we're not winning on the cards. You're just taking punishment. We're going to have another fight someday, and it ain't tonight. We're done.
And he's game. And if you keep him physically right, he can be better. He can get better. He's a young kid. No telling how soon he was thrown in against tough competition. So you need to really consider that because of his age.
You know what? I think because he is so game, I'd be in favor. I look for any excuse now if I'm in his corner to stop it, to get him out of here. Like, we know you'll fight to the end. We don't want that.
And the fact that he's going down so easy now.
Yeah. You're right. The second time he went down much easier than the first. Or the third than the second, because there's been three.
But maybe they know something we don't know in the corner. Maybe they've seen him in a fight like that and come out of nowhere and finish his opponent. So we can't question him.
Well, sure we can. But we might be wrong. Wait a second, Virgil. Yes, we can.
Well, as a trainer, I don't know him, so I can't question
I
him.
Will.
He might.
Oh, no, I mean, you make a judgment. You try to be fair. And we saw that in, earlier on Fox, where you question a referee early, and then it looked like Gerald Washington, that it was the right call on Gerald Washington.
Exactly.
Because the referee was closer, saw his eyes, could just smell the whole situation better. But I think when it comes to a stoppage, it's always a healthy discussion to say, hey, at what point does the corner step in? I don't think we're quite there, but I'd be in favor of them finding a reason. Gemino, good body shots.
Nyambayar keeps giving him a reason. If champs say to fire back, they're not going to stop it.
No, definitely not. Mm. And the only thing I argue, and it's not with you, coach, it's just with him, with the fighter, maybe his corner, is that he's letting Gemino get off. You know, I think that he could definitely take this guy out. I mean, Gemino definitely takes a lot of punishment. He takes well punches. But what I'm saying is his level of fighting from Nyambayar is, it's way higher. So he should definitely show that. Kick his ass, CBS!
We're letting him rest. Let's go. Well, he's knocked him down three times. And this is his eighth pro fight. So I understand where you're coming from, champ. There you go. The champ has been a champ for a long time.
Get off his neck.
And now you're seventh fight.
And you've been a coach longer than I've been fighting, so you know.
But it is a very entertaining fight.
It is.
Gemino pops out a double jab, and just when you think, okay, let's get him out of here, he makes it interesting. Again, been down three times, so the scoring is going to factor into this. But he's here to fight. He's a professional. He's making a professional effort.
10 seconds, boys. 10 seconds, Doc.
You have to appreciate the Bushido of Jhon Gemino. And also the class of Tugstsogt Nyambayar. Again, coming out of very difficult circumstances. An orphan lives in a small village. His dream is to just escape poverty. His trainer, Ishii Yoshikawa, Abner, has an interesting story. Did a documentary on Gemino.
Yeah, he said that we could find it on YouTube. I'll make sure I watch it. This kid definitely has a story. He's been through it all. And he's here to fight. He's proving it.
Again, firing back, uppercut and a hook. Well, he put that out, and he said, yeah, you can find it, so I'm sure you just look up Jhon and this J-H-O-N Gemino, and it's G-E-M-I-N-O. If people out there watching, you can look up anything these days, and you find a clip of it, but it really spurred people in Japan, where Yoshikawa is from, he's in Tokyo, to just send things, you know, to their gym. It could be just, you know, equipment, shirts, shoes. They don't have these things.
The problem is these type of fights is what ruins a fighter and takes him down in his career. And Jimenez being a young fighter, again, I'll just have to say, the damage that he's taking, the punches that he's taking, it's not going to help him to further his career.
So are you saying, Virgil, you wouldn't have let him out for this round?
I would have stopped it 2 rounds ago.
Okay, when you had a reason, yeah. He has been knocked down 3 times.
Young, and this is what he may have won that fighter.
You're right in that he may have won that last round, Virgil. You know, maybe I'm nuts. He may have won that round. Before that, when he was getting hurt, it could have been a reason.
He might have won the punch count, but he didn't win that round.
Yeah, the people at home scoring it, you haven't given him a round since the second round. You could be absolutely right. I'm grading on a curve at this point.
He's getting hit to the body heavy. He's getting hit to flush. See, the punches are just flush. This is what, if he gets knocked out, you know, this is not good if he goes out after this beating. He's taking a beating.
No, Virgil, I hear you. By the way, I'm not disagreeing with you. I think you find a reason to get him out of here. Because he is way too game for his own good.
Exactly. You have to save him from himself.
I mean, I might sound bad, but it'll be better if they knock him out because, you know, taking punishment like this is worse than getting a knockout.
Exactly.
Abner, I've found, you know, from my experience with fighters that world-class fighters such as yourself, you're more sensitive than an average fan even watching a guy take a beating, right?
Of course, because I'm still an active fighter. I know the pressure. I know the feeling of taking punches. So I feel for the fighter. I feel for the human being. Period.
Yeah.
You know.
I've just found that. You would just think, well, the athlete is always saying, no, keep going. No, I've seen many fighters say, you know what? You're not in the main event. You're not in a world championship fight. Let the guy out. And here, Jhon Gemino refuses to go out quietly.
Good round.
It continues, we believe. Tugstsogt and Nyambayar piles up. Gemino continues to fight.
I think he was trying to see how many rounds were left. And he saw that it was the 9th round. He had 2 more to go. And he said, all right, let's finish him.
Again, this was scheduled, and this happens a lot, for 8 or 10. And depending on how things work out TV-wise, they can make a quick switch. That happens 4-rounders, 6-rounders, 8-rounders, 10-rounders. And it just so happens here. So maybe he was wondering, or maybe we wondered, was he looking for the referee to say, hey, you know what? You know what? Maybe we're good.
I thought he was going to do so, but no, he looked up at the number of the round. He saw it was the 9th, and he said, let's keep going. You can finish him. Easier said than done. He's not the one in there, right?
That's right. And Jimenez needs a knockout to win. And it's he's way far behind in the scorecards, we can assume. And he needs a knockout to win. And so he's taking punishment to try to get this knockout. If he does, God bless him. But the punishment he's taking.
Yeah, I mean, I could see him firing back Virgil from now till the cows come home. He's not going to knock this guy out.
Exactly.
Right? It's just not going to happen. At the same time, look, we expect a professional effort. We're getting it.
Yeah.
No one's withholding this guy's purse.
Exactly. And we can never say never, but we have to be logical.
Well put. I'm just looking to the corner there at Yoshikawa to see how closely he's looking. You know, like a referee who gets closer, is he getting closer to jumping in? But doesn't quite have a reason. Like even that, okay, got hit twice, not hurt.
Well, the reason they're looking at it is you have a silver medalist in here, and if Jimenez wins this fight, because all medalists, bronze, silver, and gold, have a bullseye on their back.
Yep.
So if he wins this fight, that takes him to another level.
Oh, that's big game.
Exactly.
That guy. Abner, what do you think of Nyambayar? I mean, his general class level, what do you think is in his future?
I think he's still young. I think he's still learning. A little bit green. I think, you know, like I said, I would have done things different. But then again, I've been boxing for so many times, you know, so many years. And I see things differently. What I'm saying is that a little bit more work. But he's definitely got the tools. He's got the abilities to become a world champion. Great hook there. and he's just this another learning experience. I'm glad he's going the rounds, but definitely a fight where he's going to learn.
Good jabs there by Gemino. As he looks determined to go the distance.
And that's another reason I would stop it, because he's showing that he will fight. He's showing that he has skill and that he could get better. So why leave it here?
It's a good point. No, I think Virgil, that's a very good point. Right, because there's a future for a guy like this. Right?
He's young.
He could beat a lot of people.
He's game, he's young. He's going to give anybody a tough fight at the level that he's at right now.
Even that combination he just threw in the final seconds of the ninth round, where he's been down three times, mm-hmm. tells you something.
Exactly.
Tonight on FS1, we've had five all together. We had three over on Fox. Caleb Plant and Thomas Awimbono up next. And Plant, an exciting young fighter. He's also 24, like these two. He's 14-0 with 10 KOs. And we get to the final round here. As you see on the throwdown scoring app, wide margin for Tugstsogt Nyambayar. Deservedly so, but just a good matchup here. Gemino making the most of things.
Gemino's got hit with eight flush punches.
These punches are coming much harder now from Nyambayar. He looks like he wants to close the show. Down goes Gemino. I tell you what, Nyambayar just put it into fifth gear, fellas.
Yes.
Those were coming harder.
You okay?
And he knows Gemino has to look for a knockout to win, so Gemino's going to leave himself a little bit more open. See?
Hard right hand. He's been knocked down four times. We're getting close to where this should stop. Hard shots coming in. Another right hand. Nyambayar.
Yeah, they should definitely stop it.
He's hanging in. He's on loose feet, and it's over. That's a few seconds perhaps too late, but it's over.
It's good.
And a well-deserved win.